Describe your first date using only one word.
Dildos.
We actually were done with the Q&A, and this was like, this was perfect because I think this is the only way that we could explain it. Our first date.
We met up, we went to Dairy Queen.
We just wanted to get some ice cream, man. That's all we wanted to get. So anyway, it was actually at the end of the date, and we were like about to leave Dairy Queen. So we're like standing there by our cars, and then I don't know what happened. Like, there was some creepy dude across the street being all weird.
Oh yeah, he kept pulling into the driveway and then leaving, and kept pulling back in and leaving. So if you are actually part of his channel, we are sorry to mention you, but this is just hilarious.
But basically, we were standing there in the rain, and I don't know how we got in the conversation of dildos, but we did.
I think I brought it up, actually.
And then all of a sudden, there was, like, some old dude in a car full of kids with all of the windows down right behind her, and she's talking about dildos.
And I basically, like, screamed the word dildo at
her. Dildos!
And then this old guy just, like, peers over and stares at me. And we're just dying.
What is up, everybody? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to another video. Today, we're playing some Black Ops 3. I have three gameplays in this one because today I'm joined with Mrs. Prestige.
Hi, everybody.
And today we're going to be doing a Q&A, which we started over on Twitter. If you guys don't, shameless plug, follow me up on Twitter. That way, when you know my videos go live, you'll see it there. When I do a Q&A, you'll see it there. And of course, you can just communicate with me over there. I always respond. For the most part, unless I'm sleeping. But anyway, let's move on to the Q&A. We're going to start with our very first question, and it's coming from Elliot, and this one's directed directly at me. If Call of Duty didn't exist, would you still be doing YouTube? This is a good question, because I didn't necessarily start this YouTube channel with Call of Duty. I did play a majority of Call of Duty, but I would definitely still be doing YouTube in some way, shape, or form, whether that would be with retro games or doing like live action skits or something along the lines of that. There's a lot more stuff that I want to do in 2017. Stay tuned for that. All right, next question coming from Ammo Pop Tart asking, how did you guys meet? You want to answer that?
Well, we met way back in high school. It was 11th grade in English class. It was.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
Long time ago, actually. And I remember this kid, Mr. Prestige here, would always try to sit behind me. Just because you liked me that much in high school, you had to sit right behind me all the time.
You can't blame me for that.
And when you got separated, you blamed the teacher and said you learned better behind me. It was great.
And who got back there? The teacher put me back there because I said that.
Yeah, because you said you learned better behind me.
I did. I was able to... I'm not going to answer the rest of that. I did better behind you. You're right. All right, next question coming from Pierre saying, how did you two meet?
We just answered that.
So, okay, we'll move on to the next one. Stuart, what inspired you to make YouTube videos? Any tips for new YouTubers? Love the videos. Keep it up. Thank you, Stuart. So what inspired me to do YouTube? It was really just the inception of the site. When it comes to the gaming side of things, there was a few YouTubers that did inspire me, but I don't really want to mention them anymore since I don't really find them favorable at this point. They've done a lot of really shitty things over their career, so I don't really look up to them anymore. But I've been doing YouTube basically since it started in some way, shape, or form, whether it was dubbing our voices over cartoons and stuff and just making funny videos or, just doing funny things like that, like skits. If I had any advice for new YouTubers, don't give up, just keep doing it. I mean, it's like a roller coaster ride. Like, right now, my channel's doing pretty shitty, to be completely honest with you guys, and it's kind of depressing, but I'm gonna push through it, and, obviously, this has happened before in the past, so I'm not really worried about it. The last time this happened was actually Call of Duty Ghosts, to be completely honest with you guys, and that kind of sucked, but oh well. All right, moving on to the next question, we have T-Web. Can we get some Titanfall 2 videos from you this year? I've actually uploaded some over on my second channel, shameless plug. I would recommend checking it out, link down below in the description. Experiment, what made you want to start YouTube and have you ever wanted to quit? This kind of rolls into the last question that Stuart asked. I started YouTube pretty much since it came out just because I thought it was a cool idea. And have I ever wanted to quit? I've thought about it a lot, actually. I've thought about quitting a lot, and that's simply because I know YouTube is not going to be here forever. I know YouTube is not a forever guaranteed, you're good to go. There's a lot of things that I want to do in life, and I don't think YouTube is something that I want to do forever, if that makes any sense.
If all else, I can take over.
She can take over the channel. All right, next up we have my boy Carnage asking, how long have you been together and how did you meet?
So, well, we already answered how did you meet. It was in high school.
Yeah, we've been together, well,
quite a few years.
We met in high school, so just...
We'll just stick with that.
We'll just stick with that. So just think of how long ago I was in high school. See,
since high school, junior year.
We graduated in 2010, so just put that together.
Put that in your head, yeah.
It's been a while. All right, next up, we have Navy asking, do you both play Call of Duty and how good are you?
Actually, I have never played Call of Duty, so, well, not never. We did try to play a little multiplayer once, and I was terrible at it. But that's because this kid wouldn't give me a break and let me learn the damn controls before he'd try to kill me five times.
That was also Advanced Warfare, though, so, I mean, that's kind of like a new learning curve. Yeah. She plays, like, Skyrim.
I play Skyrim, Halo, Fable, you name it, those old school games. I even play older games from, like, the PS2, the regular Xbox, so I play those.
And, like, Guitar Hero and stuff.
I haven't played Guitar Hero in a while, but I do have a Wii console that we should totally bring on the second channel one day.
All right, I think that sounds good.
Oh, yeah. Let me know what you guys think in the description below.
In the comments.
Same
She's
thing.
Learning YouTube, don't worry.
I am learning YouTube because eventually I want to do my own account. So let me know if you guys want me to do that as well.
All right. Well, I say in the description below sometimes. Anyway, Christian Prouty Gaming asks, do you like / collect knives? That's actually a funny question.
That is a funny question. I would say for you, not necessarily. You collect more of the gun side, not really knives.
I have two firearms and then I have two survival knives. I have a katana.
Oh, yeah. Don't you have a machete, too?
I have a machete. I guess I do kind of collect knives.
I guess you do.
All right. Let's move on to the next one. We have
Drizzity.
Are you guys going to do any challenges while playing together? That would be cool.
We should actually consider doing that one of these days.
No, I definitely had some ideas for the second channel.
Yeah.
So that'd be cool.
Put it this way. We will definitely be considering it. We don't know what game for yet, but we're definitely putting it into thought.
All right, we have Lewis asking, if you were not doing YouTube, what would be your career? Before YouTube, I have done a lot of different jobs. And it was just more or less me feeling and testing the waters for what I really like. The first job that I did that I actually considered a real job was just working at a grocery store. I mean, that was literally my first job. And that, you know, grocery stores jobs can be forever, especially if you're there for a long time, get a bunch of raises, work your way up in the system. But it just wasn't for me. I literally did everything at that job, too, from produce all the way to meat department to everything.
Yeah, and I would always punch you down in the store and be like, hey, where's this stuff?
Right? So, yeah, then I couldn't even escape her there.
Hey.
But anyway, what else would I do? I actually worked at Radio Shack for a while until they kind of shut down because they had a terrible business model.
You were the best one there,
though. I was the best one there.
Yes, you were.
I kept that place. I was selling cell phones like crazy.
Old people loved you.
Yeah, the old people always come in, hey, I got a new battery for my cordless phone.
Okay, let's not make fun of the old people on here.
I'm not making fun of the old people. That's how they talk.
All right, let's continue
okay,
on.
Okay, but legit, if I was not doing YouTube, I would probably be doing like HVAC like I was doing before, which I could always go back and do. And if I wasn't doing that, then maybe contracting with the military again, but the only downside to that is I was gone all week.
Yeah, you were gone for a long time.
Yeah, and it's not good because I lose communication with like everybody.
He did. He's not lying.
All right, next.
We already answered that one, so the
next
one.
Question we have from Prince asking, what are you going to do in 2017 that will change you?
Ooh, that's a good question.
That is a good question. I don't know if I can really answer that. I mean, there's a lot that I want to do in 2017 that's different. On the YouTube channel, at least, simply because I want to try to branch out and do more, not necessarily just with Call of Duty, but like other things. Like if you guys have noticed, I've been doing a lot of retro gaming stuff, unboxing PS2, unboxing the PS1. I've been doing a lot of product and tech reviews, and that's just because these are things that I like to do. And as a consumer and as someone who has access to get these products, I think it's awesome to be able to share that knowledge with all of you before you actually purchase something And, you know, you get, like, an educated actual, like, review from somebody who is using these products every single day. So, tech reviews is kind of something that I've always really liked doing, but I never really did unboxings to the extent that I've been doing now and kind of doing reviews of that. So, that's something that I want to do to kind of change a little bit. Otherwise, I'll still be playing video games. I'll still be playing Call of Duty.
Maybe they meant this question as, like, a personal question. What personally is going to change for you in 2017?
What's personally going to change for me in 2017? I think I want to swim more. Does that make sense?
I don't think that's exactly what was meant, but we'll go with that.
Oh, come on.
So you want to be more active. Yeah, so he wants to get out and have more of a life. We'll put it that way.
Yeah, I want to have more of a life. I have no life right now.
Yeah, he's stuck in his office, and I'm stuck hiding in the other room on my computer all day, so he probably just wants to be able to see me a little bit more often.
All right, next up we have Matt asking, how does Mrs. Prestige feel about your YouTube career? I can't
No, that's a good question.
I don't think I've ever heard this answer, so I'm bracing myself.
Honestly, at first when I heard about this, I was like, really? You can make a career out of this? But now that I look into it and see how much he actually loves it, it's like, wow. You can put what you love and make it into a career, and you can support yourself with it. That's truly incredible. And I have to say, I am very proud of him. So I know you hit a little rough patch. I hit a rough patch with my career too, so you just gotta push through and move on and keep up the good work.
Well, it's not all me. If it wasn't for the viewers, then I wouldn't be.
Well, of course, but you're doing what you love so that way you could get your viewers and your fans and your subscribers. It's because of you starting that you have all these fans.
I guess so. I never really looked at it that way. Alright. Next up, SRK.
Do you play any mobile games?
Mobile. I don't, but I know that Mrs. Prestige does.
I am on my phone and my tablet, like, all the time. It is insane. I mean, like, I've drained my phone battery 4 times in a day being on games so much.
That's probably too much.
Yeah, it's too much.
Well,
but
also, your battery sucks ass.
My battery does suck. I know this. I need a new battery, but if I wait a little bit longer, I'll be able to upgrade my phone. But what about you? You play that one game on your computer. I mean, it's not really mobile, but it can be.
Well, I guess the only mobile game I'd play is it's kind of like Clash of Clans. Like, I think it's like Clash of Clans where you build. It's called Call of Duty Heroes. I mean, it's just a Call of Duty game.
Yeah.
But that's mobile, so I used to play that a lot, but I don't play it anymore.
He can't get away from Call of Duty, as you can see.
I know, what the hell? It's like, got me trapped. All right, next up. We have Eros asking, have you ever had interest in other artistic mediums, music, painting, or art? Well, I love to draw.
He does love to draw. He's actually really good at it. You guys will have to ask him to draw something for you guys at some point, because he is actually a pretty damn good artist. And
as for music, it'll be like 3 in the morning, and I'll be sitting there singing in bed.
He'll randomly sing throughout the night.
And I'll start, like, screaming.
He actually does scream, I kid you not. Like, I'll be sleeping there and all of a sudden I hear, ah! And I'm like, are you serious?
Yeah,
right
but
now?
I'm singing. But ugh. I feel like that basically if you have fun doing something, then why stop doing it, you know?
Well, you know, like for me, if I was to answer this question, it would be I used to play the violin, so obviously I love music, but at some point I haven't had time to play it anymore. So it comes to a point where sometimes career takes over the other things you enjoy doing. Like, I do love music. I do love drawing, even though I'm kind of sucky at it. Mm-hmm. And I painted you that picture, you know, and that was kind of sucky, but you accepted it anyway, you know? So, I mean, sometimes you just have to make time for it, and maybe that's what you need to do for this next year.
More singing. More singing on YouTube for everybody.
Please do. That'd be great. All right. Next question is from Drew. To me, what is your favorite thing about Ryan that we don't get to see through his social media presence? Oh, my goodness. That's a bit of an interesting question. I don't know if I can really answer that because you guys see how genuine he is online. I mean, he's the same in person. So it's not like there's anything different to say, really. But yeah, I don't know how to answer that. I know,
everything I do online is the same that I do in real life.
Exactly how he acts online, he's the same in person. So if you guys have ever met him, then you obviously know this. So
yeah,
the
so
same
like,
loving, genuine guy he is in person, he is through with you guys. So,
like, what you're trying to say is if one of these guys met me in real life, which I've had that happen before.
You have had that happen, yeah.
Like, if they met me in real life, they'd just be like, oh, like buddies, because they like basically
yeah,
know me.
Yeah, they're basically like your buddy, and, you know.
That's kind of a cool way to put it.
Yeah.
All right, this is going to be one of the final questions. We have SRK asking, can you please make a video with your friends goofing off in IW, like some sort of funny montage? I have something in the works, actually.
Oh, goodness.
I was singing a song while playing Infected. I think you're going to really like it.
All right, I'm going to ask you a few more questions, and then that will be it for today.
This is going to be the last question.
No, there's another one.
No, this is going to be the last question right
Okay,
here.
We're fighting over this already, so go on ahead, and then I will ask you one more, and then we're done.
Okay, what is your dream car? I would honestly just, like, probably like an Escalade.
Question is from Louis CPK. Do I play Call of Duty? I do not, but honestly, seeing as often as Ryan plays it, I am probably gonna start getting into it. And then last question from Max Bazil, if you would stop scrolling the screen. Do you and Mrs. Prestige have a game that y'all play together? I think we need to answer this one. At least I try to get you to play games with me, so...
I mean, we've played Minecraft.
We've played Minecraft. I'm trying to get him to do Halo with me.
But I hate playing Halo.
I know.
It's not the same like it used to be. Like, if you were to ask me back in Halo 3, like, yo, let's go play, it'd be done. Like,
it'd be done.
I love Halo 3.
So, you guys, let us know if you want to see anything different with the two of us for this year on his YouTube.
Yeah, guys, if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to click the like button down below. I want to send a big thank you once again to all of my new patrons over on Patreon. If you guys want to support me over there, check it out. Link down below in the description. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. Until next time, I'll see ya.
Peace.
Peace.